Spanish is not much better than the last time we were here, so I will keep my talking to a bare minimum. I'm sure you've come to hear the music anyway. The music that we will perform tonight is largely music that inspired me to become involved in Celtic music and leave my veterinarian studies. In the Celtic culture, the Celts were known for not having written anything down, and that theirs was an oral tradition. This next piece is a contemporary extension of that. It's called The Highwayman.
A bunch of laces cheap, Shattered to the rest of the moonlight, he wanted to breathe it down.
Some of those who emigrated came to Canada on timber ships, particularly to a quarantine station off of Quebec City called Gros Isle. And in the early 1980s, I was working on a one-woman musical production based on the Irish coming to Canada at that time. I never finished it, but these next two melodies come from that project. They're called the Emigration Tunes.
don't want to come to my mother's house in the moonshine here. I go to the door and I let you in. People of the world will hear us with me to re I for a little day.
Of writers for the theatre as well as poets that were associated with the Abbey Theatre in Dublin. And one of those poets was W.B. Yeats. He was very interested in the mythology and folklore of the Celts and wove that into his poetry. He was also madly in love with a woman called Maud Gonne through a lot of his life. She, in turn, was much more interested in the politics at the time and was in love with a man called John McBride, and not so much with W.B. Yeats. So this next poem, which is a Yeats poem and set by someone to music over 100 years ago, I often think that perhaps Yeats had Maud Gonne in mind when he wrote it. It's a piece called Down by the Sally Gardens.
Thank you.
Many people believe that I come from Ireland, but in actual fact, I grew up in the middle of the Canadian prairies. But I took a keen interest in the Celtic music once I heard it. Like many people around the world, have recognized there's something quite infectious in that music. This is also the moment that I'd like to take the opportunity to introduce you to the people that I have a very, very great pleasure of sharing the stage with each night. It is an extraordinary thing to work with such talented individuals. So beginning on my left-hand side, up on pipes, clarinet, whistling for Mr. Ian Parker. Dudley Phillips. On drums and percussion, Mr. Roy Dodds. On guitars and bouzouki, Mr. Tony McManus. Guitars and oud, Mr. Brian Hughes. On cello, Miss Caroline Lavelle. And on violin, Mr. Hugh Marsh.
shelter, oh, and where will we sleep? For the oak and the ash are all cut down, and the walls of Bonnyport are down to the ground.
Crossroads of time, and I wondered why.
cast our gaze on the trembling sea, a vision came o'er me, of thundering hoofs and beating wings in clouds above. As eternity go, I heard you call. Spreading its wings to fly, the always are lost. You sang as you flew, and I wondered why. The thundering waves are calling me home, home to you. Thank you. This glancing life is like a morning star, a setting sun or rolling waves at sea, a gentle breeze or lightning in a storm, a dancing dream of all eternity. The sand was shimmering in the morning light, and dancing off the dew so far away. The night held the music so sweet, so long, and there we lay until the break of day. We woke that morning at the onward call. A camera's bright and up our hood as full. The sun was rising in the eastern sky, just as we set out to the desert's cry. Smaller as we rode away on earth that tells of many passing days, the months of peace on the years of war, the lives of love and all the lives of fears. The river beds all etched in stone, and up the muddy mountain seven moon, beyond the valleys in the searing heat, until we reach the caravanserai. This life that pulls me far away, what is that home where we cannot reside, what is that quest that pulls me on my road? My heart is full when you are by my side. Calling you, you.
Thank you.